Top Stories is brought to you by Dawa Khana, Rehari, Chungi, Jammu. President Donald Trump has made it clear that his offer of mediation on Kashmir is not on the table anymore, the Indian ambassador has said. Ambassador Harshvardhan Shringla has said America's decades-old policy on Kashmir has been no mediation but to encourage India and Pakistan to resolve their differences bilaterally. Chief General Bipin Rawat on Tuesday said Pakistan deploying additional military resources along the line of control in Jammu and Kashmir over the last few days is normal and not a matter of concern. Asserting that Indian troops are prepared to deal with any security challenge in the region, the Army Chief said every country takes precautionary measures and there is no reason to worry about the deployment of additional forces by Pakistan along LOC. Jammu and Kashmir administration on Tuesday said it is hopeful of further relaxations in the security clampdown after the dress rehearsal for the August 15 Independence Day celebrations conclude in various districts. Principal Secretary Rohit Kansal told a press conference here that while prohibitory conditions were relaxed in various parts of Kashmir, the Jammu region was almost entirely free of restrictions. In the wake of demolition of Guru Ravidas temple and removal of an idol in Tughlakabad area of Delhi, various organizations and associations under the banner of Sri Guru Ravidas Sabha on Tuesday staged protest and blocked River Tavi Bridge. Mata Vaishno Devi Shrine Board on Tuesday appealed to the pilgrims from across the country that the pilgrimage to the cave shrine is smoothly progressing and do not pay heed to rumours, an official Twitter handle of the Shrine Board wrote on microblogging site. The Supreme Court has refused to interfere in administrative restrictions imposed on communication and people's movement in the aftermath of removal of the special status enjoyed by Jammu and Kashmir under Article 370. The top court said it was too early for it to intervene and it was against playing the role of a day-to-day administrator. The court adjourned hearing on the plea for 2 weeks. Railway employees in the region have been put on alert and have been asked to be present at their workplaces. Security has been beefed up at all the railway stations including at Jammu, Udhampur, Katra, Kathua and Samba and on tracks. Checking and frisking at railway stations have been increased and patrolling on track intensified. Dress rehearsals were held on Tuesday for the Independence Day celebrations across Jammu Division. The events witnessed large participation of school children, civil society members, contingents of Belt Force personnel, senior civil and police functionaries. Tuesday issued an advisory to its citizens for travelling to Hong Kong a day after flight operations were severely disrupted at the city's international airport due to public demonstrations on August 12. Hong Kong Airport Authority within a short notice on Monday suspended all remaining flights for the day after thousands of pro-democracy protesters entered the terminal's arrival halls. President Rahul Gandhi Tuesday hit back at Jammu and Kashmir Governor Satyapal Malik and said that he, along with a delegation of opposition leaders, will take up his gracious invitation of flying to the state that is currently under a lockdown to take stock of the situation provided they are given the freedom to do so. Former Prime Minister and veteran Congress leader Manmohan Singh on Tuesday filed nomination papers for a Rajya Sabha seat in Rajasthan. Singh earlier was a Rajya Sabha member from Assam. Ahead of the Independence Day, Union Minister Prakash Javedkar launched a new patriotic song titled Vatan, celebrating the essence of New India. It has been produced by Doordarshan. The song has been beautifully shot and will ignite your patriotic passion. The track pays a tribute to the nation and especially it touches upon the essence of New India. Pakistan Iran's Foreign Minister Shah Mahmood Qureshi has said it will be a tough task to get the support of United Nations Security Council and the Muslim world against India's decision to revoke Jammu and Kashmir's special status. While asking his countrymen not to live in a fool's paradise, Qureshi said Pakistanis need to wake a new struggle to get the support of the UNSC members. India's domestic passenger vehicle sales fell for the ninth straight month in July, an auto industry body said on Tuesday. Amid a deepening crisis in the country's automobile sector that has triggered large-scale job losses, sales of passenger vehicles to car dealers fell 30.9% to 2,790,000 in July. Data released by the Society of Indian Automobile Manufacturers showed commercial vehicle sales fell 25.7% to 56,866 units.